Today, I will give you 3 tips that you can use to score higher in salsa competitions, as well as 1 big mistake that you should avoid in order to prevent yourself from losing points. I have won 12 Salsa World Championships myself, and I have currently judged 7 different competitions around Latin America, as well as the US and Europe. And throughout my whole salsa career, of course, I have always tried to learn from the most world-renowned judges and just be able to learn how they think, right? And it kind of used that to my advantage to be able to score higher. And I will try to share that information to you as best as possible, basically just to save you time in your competition journey. So of course, every salsa competition has its own rules. In general, I would say around 80% kind of have very similar qualifying topics, right? We have timing, technique, presentation, difficulty. So the first tip that I can give you, even though it may sound very obvious, a lot of people end up losing points or even being disqualified completely from competitions because they didn't follow the rules that were applied specifically for that competition. So remember that not all competitions are the same. So you always want to make sure that you read the rules before you decide to register and compete, because it may mean that you will have to tweak or change some aspects of your choreography to be able to compete and be able to score well in this specific type of competition. So that is tip number 1. Make sure to listen out for the tip number 3, because I think it's the most important one, and it will certainly be the one that helps you increase your score the most. Now, tip number 2 is to dance more. Remember, if this is a salsa competition, you are being judged on your salsa skills, right? It's not a tricks competition, it's not a ballet competition, it's not a contemporary competition, it is a salsa competition. So you will be judged based on your salsa. I promise you, no judge in their right mind will tell you to dance less salsa. Of course, if you have an extra element here and there, it can certainly help if your salsa skills are very good. But if you are basically just starting out, I promise you, if you dance more, if you use your basics more, you will be scored way better than somebody that is just trying to impress or get claps or get wows from the public, or maybe even from the judges, just by adding elements that are not even from salsa. So it sounds pretty obvious, but I promise you that not a lot of people take that very seriously, and they end up suffering in their scores, because even though they are amazing dancers, remember, this is a salsa competition, so you're going to be based on your skills that apply to salsa. And within this same tip, I can also mention, like, a bonus part of this tip is to try to, it's not only about doing your basic, right? It's like, yes, I mean, dance more salsa, but that can mean try different ways of using patterns within your basic to do variations of footwork, right? Or different kinds of partner work, right? Try to be original in the way that you use your salsa, right? So it's still using elements from salsa, but how can you present something that is different, that is original, still using the basics to make it look clean and original, is definitely something that will work a lot in your favor. Now, there is one big mistake that you want to avoid at all costs, and that is that in order to try to be more musical or try to hit the musicality of the music, that it's very common that people stop stepping their basics or stop dancing salsa to kind of do poses or other types of movement just to connect with the music a little bit better. And what you should try to do is try to connect with the music, try to be musical, like hit that musicality whilst doing steps. Whether you're doing footwork, partner work, or tricks, make sure that you're hitting this musicality while you're dancing salsa. Like, try not to stop your steps to kind of move your body in a way that will hit the music, just because if you stop dancing, if you stop stepping your feet, that will definitely hurt you in the most important category of all, that is timing. So you just want to be very careful that you don't sacrifice your basics and don't sacrifice your steps to be musical, and try to combine both of these elements, you know, try to combine your timing in a way that it can also connect with the music. So it's not easy, that's actually very hard. So, but again, try to do this, and I promise you that you will score higher in your competitions. Now, I think a very important fact about myself is that have in fact lost a lot of times. Like, a lot of people only remember the wins, or people usually just remember the good things and the achievements. But I remember there was a time that I think I did not get first place when I started as a soloist. I think I competed about 18 times for about 2 years and a half. without winning first place. You could say that I lost 18 times in a row before getting my first place for 2 years and a half, and you really want to, but that is part of the process. That is very important that every time you compete, I promise you will learn something. And if you continue to improve time after time, if you focus on improving and getting feedback and changing things 1% each time that you compete, improve a little bit more, I promise you that will add up and it will make a huge difference. As I told you, I think I competed about, I was counting at the time because I was like, my God, this is too much. I would get sometimes very close, but I still didn't pull it off. And you want to train and get to a level, well, there is no doubt that you won the competition. That's how good you want to get. So I think it was about 18 times that I lost before I was able to win my first place as a soloist. And guess what? After I won the first place as soloist, I think I proceeded to win about 12 times in a row. Like I could say that I was unbeatable in that moment of my career, that I would perform because I improved my salsa so much that I would score very high, and it was very hard for me to lose. Trust me, when you lose is the moments where you learn the most. So you actually want to use those moments in your favor to grow a lot more, and don't get carried away by, especially if you win a competition where there was not that many good competitors or really a good level that would challenge you. There is no reason that you should like over celebrate or think you overachieved something, because you really should measure yourself on how much you are improving and how much you are learning. And even sometimes it's better, I would say, in my opinion, it will help you a lot more to lose than to win because of how much it will make you grow. So that is just a fun fact. And now this final tip that I think is the one that helped me the most throughout my career and throughout the competitors that I see that continue to win in competitions that they participate in is the timing. So timing has a lot of aspects, and I think I can break it down in two parts. The first one is try to make it easy for the judges to see your timing when you do your choreography. So if you are doing steps, for example, if you're dancing salsa on two, make sure that it's easy for the judge to see your basic throughout the turn patterns, right? If you're doing turn patterns, make sure that you're always stepping and the judge can always see your timing, and that it's just make the job easier for the judge. You want to be smart about it because the judge is seeing a lot of things, you know, maybe they've judged already like hundreds of competitors before you. There's people screaming behind, there's the lights going on, there's the music, there's a lot of information going around. So you just want to make sure that you're smart about it and just don't try to complicate or switch your timing in weird ways that because you think it is more musical. Try to make your basic and your timing super clear for the judges. It doesn't mean do easy things, you know, it just means keep your timing while trying to do difficult things, you know. For example, a basic with very good body movement is very hard, you know, or doing intricate partner work without losing your basic step, that is also hard. So there is no reason why you should step in weird ways that don't go with the basic to kind of be musical. When you actually want to do is add difficulty within your basic step so that your timing isn't affected. And the second thing that I can say about your basic is not to get too excited. I know it happens a lot, especially to me. I think it's something very common that happens to on two dancers, is that we are maybe kind of nervous or very excited, especially when we do partner work, and we will start to step on our eights and our fours or seven and a half, and you really want to keep your basic nice and clean. You know, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, is that what you're doing? Or if you're gonna do a sun intention, like a Cuban sun intention, and like step in on the 8, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, just make it very obvious that that's what you're doing and not that you can't control your timing and then you're getting ahead or getting delayed because you're nervous or because you're anxious. So yeah, basically with timing, number one, you want to keep your choreography to match with the basic count as much as possible, and number two, just make sure that your tempo is consistent and that you don't get ahead or delayed in your basic, as it will look like you're not in domination of your body while keeping your tempo. So that's something very important. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe if you really enjoyed this content, and comment down below any other topics that you might want me to cover. I will be more than happy to share as much as possible as I can and help you out throughout your salsa journey. See you. Bye-bye.